Hello friends, welcome to Easy English with me, Saujanya. Please subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell for more updates. Let us start today's session. Now, let us discuss reflexive and emphatic pronouns. Reflection means mirror image, okay? And emphatic, giving emphasis to the noun that is used in the sentence. That is the basic difference. I wanted to explain both of them at a time because I want to avoid any sort of confusion regarding the usage of reflexive and emphatic pronouns. How does that confusion happen? Let me explain you, okay? So by definition, reflection means mirror image. We use reflexive pronoun in a sentence when we want to say that both the subject and object are one and the same. Doer of the action and receiver of the action are one and the same. Okay? Now, emphatic pronouns we use when we want to emphasize on the noun mentioned in the sentence, giving some extra stress on that. We want to emphasize that particular noun. If you look at the examples, the dog saw itself in the mirror. What do we mean by that? Do you get the meaning of this sentence? The dog saw who in the mirror? Itself. This is the object and this is the subject. So, subject and object are one and the same. If you are still confused about what is object, I don't know what is this, then break down the sentence into who is the doer, what did he or she do, and who is the receiver of the action. Then you will get it very clearly, very easily. Okay. The dog saw itself in the mirror. Here the dog is the subject. What did it do? It saw whom? Itself. Its mirror image. Okay. Object is itself. Both object and the subject are one and the same. Then only we can use reflexive pronoun. Whereas, look at the second one. She herself went to the market. What does it mean? Here, she is the subject. There is no object in this. So, no object of the verb in this sentence. Okay. She went to the market. Does it make complete sense to you? Yeah, of course. It is a simple sentence, a single clause which has complete meaning. She went to the market. But we want to emphasize on certain thing. What is that? What are we saying? She herself. We can assume two things over here. One is she is really from a very big rank in the society. Usually that kind of things are done by her servants or her employees also. One assumption is that. Second assumption is she sent nobody else but she herself went to the market. Might be some reason we don't know. Might be some important reason we don't know at all. But who went to the market? She herself. Okay. Here it is emphatic pronoun. We are emphasizing on the subject doing something. Okay. Here, what are we referring here? Here, we are referring that object and subject are one and the same. Okay. Then it becomes reflexive. Here, herself is giving extra emphasis on the noun she, on the subject she. Okay. We are giving extra emphasis on she doing something. Okay. On her own. Then it becomes emphatic. The major difference between reflexive and emphatic pronouns is you can't remove a reflexive pronoun from the sentence without altering the meaning. It is impossible. Now look at this. The dog saw in the mirror. What did it see? Immediate. The dog saw in the mirror. It is an incomplete sentence without this reflexive pronoun. You can't remove reflexive pronoun from the sentence without changing its meaning. Whereas in emphatic pronoun system, you can comfortably take this out. It doesn't alter the meaning much. Okay. Even if you remove emphatic pronoun from the sentence, it gives a complete sentence. Okay. For example, she went to the market. There is subject, there is predicate. Complete, meaningful sentence. Okay. That is the major difference between reflexive and emphatic pronouns. Reflexive pronouns can't be removed from the sentence without altering the meaning, whereas emphatic pronouns can be comfortably removed from the sentence. There is not much change in the meaning. Of course, we wanted to intensify the meaning. We want to specify on the subject doing something very clearly. We may not do that if we remove this emphatic pronoun from the sentence, but we get subject and predicate, we get complete sentence, unlike a reflexive pronoun. Look at the third one. He cut himself while cutting vegetables. What is this pronoun? What is this pronoun used here? Reflexive or emphatic? Yeah, you have identified it right. He cut who? Himself. This is the object. Who cut him? He himself. Okay, this is the subject. So, both the subject and object are one and the same. So, as a rule, this is a reflexive pronoun sentence. If you have any doubts regarding this, remove this and try to read the sentence. He cut while cutting vegetables. He cut whom? Immediately the question arises. That means there is no proper meaning in this sentence. Okay? He cut while cutting vegetables. He cut whom? Himself. So this reflexive pronoun can't be removed. Okay, as a rule, it must be a reflexive pronoun. It is not emphatic pronoun, because you can't remove it and still get the complete meaning from the sentence. Is it clear? Now I will write one more sentence. Look at the sentences. He himself cut vegetables. Okay, he is the subject here. Cut is the verb. Vegetables is the object. Now what is this? Read the sentence without this. He cut vegetables. Still, it is a meaningful sentence. So as a rule, it is emphatic pronoun. Emphatic pronoun. Okay, he himself cut vegetables. Might be His Highness, might be from very superior rank, or in our male dominated society, okay, women are supposed to cut vegetables. We don't know the intention of the writer over here, okay, but he himself, we are emphasizing on the subject. Himself can be comfortably removed from this sentence till we get some meaning out of that sentence. Look at the second one. He cut vegetables himself. What does it mean? The same as this sentence. There is no difference at all. Same meaning. He cut vegetables himself. You can omit this comfortably, happily. He cut vegetables, till you can get the meaning over here. Okay. I want to tell you the structure of the sentence over here. Emphatic pronoun can either be used immediately after the subject or at the end of the sentence. It doesn't make any difference at all. And still you can comfortably remove this emphatic pronoun. Okay. If you don't know what is emphatic pronoun, by looking at the sentence, you are really confused whether it's a reflexive pronoun or emphatic pronoun. Immediately you try to do one thing, remove that pronoun from the sentence and read it. If you are able to get meaning, that means it is emphatic. If you can't get the meaning without that pronoun, that means it is reflexive. It is as simple as that. Okay. Let us look at the reflexive and emphatic pronouns in English language. First one, I, myself. We, ourselves. You, In singular form, yourself, and in plural form, yourselves. He, himself. She, herself. It, itself. They, themselves. Is it clear? Say once again with me. I, myself. We, ourselves. You can be yourself or yourselves. He, himself. She, herself. It, itself. They, themselves. I have observed many of my students doing one mistake, that is usage of non-existing reflexive pronouns. Ourself, we don't have that. Our is always plural. It will always have selves, not self. Okay. His self. Now this is also a mistake. We are supposed to say himself, not his self. Okay. And themselves. As I have told you, they is plural, so it should be selves, themselves, their selves. We don't have that word at all. Okay. So these are the only seven words. Okay. These are the seven personal pronouns and these are their reflexive pronouns. We don't have any other reflexive or emphatic pronouns other than these. Okay. And one more mistake what I observed my students doing was myself, Saujanya. You can never introduce yourself like that. You have to introduce by your name. I am Saujanya. You are not showing your mirror image and telling the audience or people about you. I, myself in the mirror, myself, Saujanya. You can't say that. Do you understand how silly that mistake is? I am Saujanya or my name is Saujanya, but never myself Saujanya. Okay? And don't use it in the objective form. Don't replace it with the object. For example, the teacher appreciated Jaya and myself for the project. What it should be? The teacher appreciated Jaya and me. Don't replace that object with reflexive pronoun. Don't replace the objects with reflexive pronouns. Is it clear? Now that's all about reflexive and emphatic pronouns.